Fanaru Devotions for Monday, 27th March, 2023, by Apostle Grace Lubega. Titled, Understanding Divine Provision. Exodus 33 verses 2-3, KJV, And I will send an angel before thee, and I will drive out the Canaanite, the Amorite, and the Hittite, and the Perizzite, the Hivite, and the Jebusite, unto a land flowing with milk and honey, for I will not go up in the midst of thee, for thou art a stiff-necked people, lest I consume thee in the way. God promised the Israelites a land flowing with milk and honey. However, in our scripture, there is no mention of bees or cows. This is very deliberate because when one enters God's best, he or she must be ready to believe, to see things whose sources he or she cannot explain. In Joshua 24 verse 13, the Bible says, And I have given you a land for which ye did not labor, and cities which ye built not, and ye dwell in them, of the vineyards and olive yards which ye planted not do ye eat. As a child of God, you must make room in your life for things that you did not work for because the Lord designed them to come that way. There is a realm in the provisions of God that has made that possible. In John 4 verse 38, the Lord said, I sent you to reap that whereon ye bestowed no labor, other men labored, and ye are entered into their labors. Not everything you will ever own will come by the labor of your hands. Accept it. While this does not undermine the need to work hard when required to, you do not have to apologize for receiving from God what you did not sweat for. Hallelujah! Further study, John 4 verse 38, Joshua 24 verse 13. Golden nugget, when one enters God's best, he or she must be ready to believe, to see things whose sources he or she cannot explain. Prayer, loving Father, I thank you for divine provision. Thank you for the liberty to reap where I have not sowed. Thank you for the rewards of faith and not of mere works. I have made room in my spirit for cities I did not build and vineyards I did not plant, because this is my portion in Christ, in Jesus' name, Amen.